What's going on, everybody? Back at it again today with another review. And today we have that review I promised you, which is the Peterson Irish Dew, which is a Virginia burley blend. All right, let's go and get you some more information from tobaccoreviews.com. Let me put on my eyeballs. Yeah, I'm getting old, unfortunately. So I gotta wear glasses when I read. All right, the Peterson Irish Dew is a new luxury mixture of well-matured Virginia and toasted burley tobaccos with whiskey and blossom fruit undertones. The sweet hint of vanilla and a touch of chocolate arising from the toasted burley give this tobacco an exceptional finish. The blend is pressed into cakes and rubbed, enhancing the natural aroma of the tobacco. So it's made by Peterson. It's manufactured by the Scandinavian Tobacco Group. It's a Virginia burley blend, as we put down there. Flavoring, cocoa, chocolate, floral essences, vanilla, and whiskey. And the cut is ready rubbed, as we already said. And it's currently available. And you can get it at Smoking Pipes or Pipes and Cigars. And it's rather inexpensive there right now. I think Pipes and Cigars, last time I checked, had it for like $4.99. Now, the reviews on this are not really that great, all right? It's 2.3 out of 5 stars, so how bad can it really be? Who knows? We'll find out here in a second, right? Right. All right. So, there we go. And today what we're going to be using for the review is we're going to be using a pipe from the Anton Pipe Studio, which is, this is what's called a Zulu style pipe. And, the Anton Pipe Studio, you can get these pipes on Etsy or directly from them. They're based in Ukraine, so do not be expecting them to come to you quickly. It's a 9mm pipe, which reminds me. Me being unprepared, I got to make sure I got a filter in there. Yes, I do. And there you go. All right, so let's go ahead and open the package here. So completely unopened, and as you can see from the package here, very nice packaging, and it doesn't have the nicotine warnings on there like a lot of the tin tobaccos do these days. All right, there we go. I'm not getting a lot of cocoa or floral essences. To me, the aroma is reminiscent of a vanilla cake, so you're definitely getting the vanilla out of this. Alright, so, and as you guys can see, let's go ahead and see if I can get you. This is the cut. And it's not picking up very well. Oh well. Okay. But anyway, that's the cut. And moisture level is not too wet, it's not too dry. It's just right. It's kind of sticky, but yeah. Very nice cut. Very, very nice. Let's separate it a little bit, shall we? Now, after I finish this review, what I'm going to do is put this into a mason jar, into a ball jar, because that helps. But, yeah, let's go ahead and talk for a little bit. How's everybody doing? Now, I did get some questions after my last video of whether I was going to start doing some live shows again or not. And eventually I will, not anytime soon. It's just not. I'm just way too... Got way too much on my plate to do a do any kind of live shows or anything like that. So, but for right now, no. Probably around the summertime when I get more time on my hands, I'll probably start doing live shows again. But because I really like doing lives, so but don't hold your breath on it. All right, and let's see. There we go. Nice pack. Nice and loose. Not too loose, of course. And so. Now, as some of you may have heard, we're going to talk about this while I try this blend. About the thing that happened with the Raleigh Police Department and a man named Darryl Williams. Let me give you my opinion on this. Let's go and light up. Damn, that's pretty good, actually. Why it's got a... Why it's only got a 2.3 review, star review on it, I don't know. Because that's actually not bad. All right. So... So as some of you may have heard, Darryl Williams was a guy that was killed in Raleigh by the Raleigh Police Department. And everybody's trying to put this in the same lane as the Tyre Nichols case. And it's not. So what happened was Darryl Williams was pulled over by the Raleigh Police Department. He had alcohol in the car. He had marijuana in the car. And when the police searched him, they found a dollar bill that had a white powdery substance on it, which they assumed was cocaine. So they tried to arrest Mr. Williams. And he took off running. And so they pursued him and they tased him. And during the course of the tasing, apparently he screamed out, "I have heart problems." Well, I'm sorry, okay? If you have cocaine in the car, you have marijuana, and you have an open container, you're going to fucking jail. You're going to get arrested. And he has heart problems. Okay? Was the tasing the only thing that killed him? Was it, how many lines of cocaine did he do before the police pulled him over? How much alcohol did he have to drink? And how much of the run contributed to that? So there are several different factors. Should he have died? No, absolutely not. But the police, this is totally different from the Tyre Nichols case, in my opinion, because the police were trying to conduct an arrest. They were not trying to be unnecessarily cruel to this kid. Okay? Unlike with Tyre Nichols, where they just beat the shit out of him and he died. But the officers have been placed on administrative leave. They're doing an investigation into it. Of course, you have the NAACP and these other groups calling for the police officers to be charged with manslaughter and all this other stuff, which I hope they don't. Because in this case, in my opinion, the Raleigh Police Department were doing their job. And, you know, while this kid's death was tragic, I don't see it as the cops were just racial profiling him or, you know, going after him because he was black. Because I don't give a shit. If you got marijuana, cocaine, or an alcohol in your car, you're going to jail. It doesn't matter if you're white, black, or a kernel of corn. You're going to fucking jail. But, yeah, we'll see. What happened there? Yeah. We'll stop being depressing about that and go back to this tobacco. All right. So what I'm getting from this tobacco is... I'm getting a vanilla essence. This actually reminds me of the McBaron vanilla flake, is what it reminds me of. So, very, very good blend. The room note on this is pleasant. Is it a take it outside blend or a smoke it indoor blend? Depends on your spouse or your significant other. If they like the smell of tobacco, because this does not have an aromatic flavoring. I can see where some people would get put off by this because it's labeled as an aromatic, but it doesn't have an aromatic aroma. What the room note is tobacco. It's a robust tobacco flavor. It's a pleasant tobacco flavor, but it's not like cigarettes or cigars or anything like that. It's a pleasant aroma. But if your spouse or significant other doesn't like the smell of tobacco, then you're going to have to take it outside. And it's hard to keep lit, too. But it's not what? It's not moist. That's weird. No. It's not bitey or anything, so you're not going to get a lot of tongue bite on this. If you measure your cadence properly, don't smoke too hard or too fast. Yes, I like this pipe. How you people talk with pipes in your mouth, I don't know. But, yeah, that's, it's a really nice shape. I like it. I got three of these. I got the red one. I got the green one, black, and blue. Actually, four. And I bought them because with everything going on in Ukraine right now, I just wanted to kind of help those guys out. But, you know. But anyway, yeah, it reminds me of the McBaron Vanilla Flake. It's nothing spectacular or extremely, like, you know. This is not one that stands out as I gotta have it. So, ratings time. 0 being the worst. 10 being the absolute best, what would I give this tobacco? I would give it a 5.5. Really. It's average. It's good. It's affordable. And if you find it and you just need a quick smoke or whatever, pick it up. I would recommend you getting at least a pouch of it. It's actually not bad. So 2.3. I don't think is a very good review. It's a very good, fair rating for this tobacco. But, you know. All right, folks. That's all I got for you. Thumbs up if you liked it. Thumbs down if you hated it. Leave a comment. Like, subscribe. Click the bell for notifications. And I will see you guys later. All right. Peace, love, adios.